When we both started to teach LCHF to our patients, we had in mind the patients with metabolic conditions like prediabetes or obesity or diabetes. But what happened is that many of those patients were also suffering from chronic pain. And when they came back for follow-ups, they were mentioning, as a by the way, they were saying, hey, doctor, I feel great. I have lots of energy. And my pain is reduced. My pain is so much better, doctor, or my pain is gone. And at first, we're like, hey, that's cool. And then after a while, we're like, okay, something is going on here. And the interesting thing is that, you know, we attend conferences such as this one, and we read a lot of literature on the low-carb and ketogenic diet. And there is more and more evidence on the benefits of the low-carb and ketogenic diets, but not often did we come across literature on chronic pain. And if you look at this graph here, you can see that there's, you know, on one side, there's strong evidence for what we know really works, like diabetes and obesity, just to name a few. And on the right side, you can see emerging evidence. And where do you see chronic pain in there?
Nowhere.
We don't talk about chronic pain, and this is the reason we're here today. We're not pain experts, but we want chronic pain to be discussed. And we want chronic pain to be discussed in the context of low-carb and ketogenic diets.